Hello, dear medicos. We are having the honor to have Dr. Piyush Agarwal with us, rank 9 AIIMS. On the behalf of DAM family, we congrats you for such a nice, awesome success.
Thanks a lot, sir.
So, first of all, I will be asking you how you are feeling after getting such a nice achievement.
Well, it feels really good, like after working for like 4.5 years, studying for 4.5 years, then working for almost 1 year. I mean, feels good that your hard work has paid finally. So yeah, it feels brilliant.
With such a great success in top 10, if you are getting rank, I always discuss with my students that rank 1 and rank 10, there is hardly any difference. It is a matter of day. Okay, but if you can go reach up to the top 10, it is a great achievement. And I wish that in the very best of luck to you in the upcoming days, and we'll be sharing your success story with every medico, all the medicos seeing you on the across the country. So I proudly say that he is our foundation student. He joined us in third year when you were doing ENTPSM Opthal.
Yes, sir.
Prof. So in the third year he was a part of DAMS, and he for the last 3 years he have taken efforts for getting such a nice rank. So Dr. Piyush, in third year, what was your strategy? How you used to handle all the classes and class notes?
Basically, in third year, always it's like I have always been in touch with my seniors who did well in their PG exams. So I always used to consult them. So they advised me ki you should be regular with your classes. And along with that, I did, like, on weekends we used to have DAMS classes. So DAMS classes used to cover each subject in like 3 to 4 weekends, or depending on the subject size, basically. So it was like I never missed on my classes, regular classes, just for coaching. But I always gave equal importance to coaching, because over time, what I realized in third year, like once when I just entered third year, I was a little scared, I was a little apprehensive, because it was like all clinical subject, it was pretty new for me. So I really think that DAMS helped me with that. The coaching really helped me with that.
That phobia of the clinical segment.
So because they taught me how to think. It's like the most important part is you should know how to think for this exam. So I really think that.
You attended all the lectures and you made all the class notes.
Yeah, I made all my class notes.
So you have written all the class notes.
Yeah, I wrote.
So when you were writing in the later part, when you appeared for the All India, so what do you advise to the students? It is better to take the hard work of writing, or you can take the prepared material from other people?
You cannot match the the written self-written notes can never be matched by printed copy of notes. They can only work as a last resort thing. But since we all are preparing for an exam which will change, like will determine our life course, it's better if we do the hard work, we put in the hard work and we write it on our own, because then we can always develop on that. It's not just one day work, you have to develop on your notes subsequently over the subsequent years. So it matters a lot. Like if you write it on your own, you'll know where
at cortex somewhere back in the mind you are learning the things, and it is better not to follow any shortcut.
Yeah, definitely, because it makes a pictorial memory. Your notes make a pictorial memory. Once you go through them, you realize what you wrote, where you wrote, because in the exams that'll only it's just
click in the exam.
Yeah,
the gut feeling will be somewhere developed with all writing all these.
It comes back to you like in form of flashes, like the whole thing.
So how was your experience with all the faculties, and when you were writing all these class notes, you're attending the lectures, so how you feel and how you manage all these classes?
I really think that DAMS played a very vital role in helping me get rid of that phobia of clinical subjects, because in the beginning, third year, it's a drastic change, like from paraclinical, we are just directly going into clinical subjects, and you start to question a lot, and college classes, because of lack of time, we cannot clear our doubts, that's for sure. So interacting with the faculty during our coaching classes, I used to be like active with the doubts, because I never used to hold back. That's what I've always believed, because I thought if you're not questioning, then there's no point of attending the class. So I thought I always found these classes very interactive.
So after attending all the lectures in the third year and final year, you were the part of test and discussion in the internship, and your internship is still going on. The 31st of December, your internship will be over.
Yes.
So it is nothing better than this. This is one of the, you can say, best scenario where a medical internship is going to be over and you have cracked AIIMS examination in the top 10. So again, congrats for such a great success. So apart from these class notes, when you were in the internship and you were attending our test and discussion, so how you handle all the MCQs, those MCQs given in the test and discussion by our all respected faculties, were at the level of AIIMS or slightly on the higher side?
This is a little difficult question to answer, because when you're appearing for the first time for the exam, you do not exactly know what to expect. People will tell you different things. So I always, I'll be honest with that, because I always thought ki DAMS went a step ahead for preparing us, preparing us for the subjects. So yeah, I always, like, content wise, DAMS questions were to the mark, to the point. I had gave the CBT exam, and I, in those, the clinical questions, they were pretty helpful, because it's not just the questions which matter, because it's the thought process which matters. Because the questions won't repeat, you won't get the same questions, but
it will be topic which
it will be the topic and how you get through that question, how you get to the answer. You need to know how you, how to approach that question. That matters. That's what, like, practice is all about. That's what, how MCQs will help you out.
So all the MCQs of Grand Test, subject wise or test and discussion, the whole MCQ question bank, do you feel that these class notes with these question bank is as such a complete package for preparing Central Institute exams?
I believe if you can do all of the stuff, you do not need anything else.
Anything else. This is at such a complete stuff for your Central Institute exam.
Yeah,
so
no,
because
doubt
you now it. You appeared for AIIMS and PGI Chandigarh, and we wish that by evening the PGI result will be declared and you will be again getting rank in top 10. So after having this experience of these institutes, so you can say confidently that yeah, AIIMS stuff is more than sufficient for these exams.
No doubt about that.
No doubt about that. Okay. After appearing for these grand test and all these things, we are having exclusive club, DAMS club. How it played the role in this success?
Definitely, like, DAMS exclusive club is not like a one day thing. It was continuous, like when we joined DAMS in third year. So like we joined the club during that time.
2016,
yeah. So I've been on this club for 3 years now, almost 3 years. So whenever we used to, like, all of us use Facebook or something, some, we have all, like, social media platforms, we spend time on that. So once in a while in my newsfeed, like, there used to be so many questions, and I used to think that if someone is asking those questions, there must be something special about it, because they, no one will ask the regular questions. There is a reason behind why they are putting up this question. So yeah, I mean, even if I didn't know the answer, I used to at least go through the comments. So it was like a daily dose of, like, at least it used to be.
You're adding all the points which you're getting in the exclusive club.
I used to, like, there were updates also from the faculty, any subject, all the subject updates, and especially for this year, there have been so many updates. So I used to add all these updates to my notes.
In your notes.
Yeah.
So class notes with your grand test, subject-wise, with your test and discussion, with all these updates in the exclusive club.
Yeah.
So all the updates which our faculties are giving in the exclusive club, what do you feel? These updates were beneficial in your AIIMS Institute examination?
For AIIMS, you need to go prepared. You cannot, like, updates are a very, like, a special area. They'll question you on that. They'll poke you on that. So you cannot go, like, unprepared on that aspect. So you have to be very prepared, because they'll poke you on that. So updates, you have to be updated. Otherwise, they'll it'll go against you, because others will be prepared for it.
Will be having the extra edge from these updates.
So you can't lose on that front.
So and you must be using our app eMedicos. What is the role of eMedicos, all the videos and all those CID programs which we have given? How they play a role in your success?
See, there are some topics which hold special emphasis and which are a little difficult to understand. Once in a while, you need to revise them. So videos are, I believe, are a little more interactive, and interactive in the sense that you get a more visual input, and just like a basic thing, visual input holds more strength in your cortex. So I believe that whenever I found a topic little difficult to understand, I used to go through the specific topic. Obviously, I didn't go through all the videos, because you have to manage your time also.
Yeah, but that time management must be there.
Time management must be at par. So whatever I went through, like, it was really helpful for me.
Helpful. So I can conclude what we have discussed in the last few couple of minutes. Okay, class notes with all the MCQ question bank, with all the videos which we are giving in the best app, eMedicos, is sufficient for getting such a nice great rank in all India AIIMS examination.
No doubt.
Now coming back to the next level, I will be asking you 3-4 different queries, set of queries, which every medico want to ask the toppers, because every medico listening to your words across the country will take your advice as a gold standard. So out of 19, the first query, first group of questions which I'm asking you, out of 19 subjects, if I ask you, okay, now in the for the next AIIMS examination, which subject should be given more preference, or which subject you feel ke, yeah, you should be master of these subjects before preparing for AIIMS exam?
I really think you should be at par with pathology, because pathology is like the root to the everything, because it the final year subject literally branch out from pathology.
Absolutely.
So you need to be like, pathology needs to be on your tips. Then pharmacology helps you a lot, also helps you a lot with a lot of subjects. Basically, it's not just one subject. It takes over your medicine part, because if you're thorough with pathology and pharmacology, you have one half the war. In fact, more than that.
Half of the medicine half you of the have medicine, covered. Yeah.
Because you'll have time constraints. So if you have covered that part, you don't need to do anything else. Then I think anatomy also helps a lot. Anatomy helps with your ortho, and it also helps
in general surgery.
In general surgery stuff. So these 3-4 subjects, they need to be, you need to be very thorough with that, because these, they'll quiz you on the visual part, and that is very important, because it helps you build concept also. You can visualize the whole thing. You need to visualize it in your, during the exam. It's not just one subject. It helps you approach the question differently.
We are having the honor to have Dr. Piyush with us, rank 9 AIIMS Institute. Now, I will be asking you one more point. Ke out of these 19 subjects, you are saying ke patho, your pharma, your anatomy segment should be given more weightage. So now what it like, why divide all these subjects like non-clinical, clinical. So what you feel after giving AIIMS and PGI Chandigarh, ke which subject we should concentrate more on? Non-clinical, paraclinical or clinical segments?
I think no doubt paraclinical.
Paraclinical. The first year, second year subjects we should giving more concentration. Yeah,
no doubt about that.
No doubt. Okay. Now next, everybody is more interested in asking this question. This is again, you can say, vary from student to student. How many hours? This is a favorite question of every medical. Even I was in first year, so I used to ask this question. How many hours required to do these all masteries and all getting sitting on this chair, getting such a nice rank?
I really don't have any answer for that, because hours don't matter. I mean, you, what you need to face is that at the end of the day, you'll be sitting in front of a question paper. If you have put in like three, four days on a stretch also, suppose if you have done that, it doesn't matter if you don't score well. It means you're doing something wrong. So you need to approach the things in the right way, and that's what matters. And you, because we all we need to accept that all of us have different ways of working.
Yeah.
We need to accept that it's the reality. Some of us can like complete something in 6 hours. Some of us need 10 hours. But what you need to realize is ki, if you need 10 hours to do something,
you have to give those 10 hours,
because that is what is more important. You cannot just keep that as an excuse ki, because I was little slow, I couldn't make it.
Now coming on the last spell of preparation, like 2 months before I take your DVT segment and followed by CBT. So first of all, taking DVT, damage visual treat, all the slides which you have seen in DVT, what was the role of those slides? Those slides gave you a extra edge in your AIIMS Institute. What is the level of motivation which you got from these DVT sessions?
DVT was like a whole recap of everything. When I attended DVT, I was little, like in the morning when you go to DVT, you see so many students like entering the stadium, you get a little apprehensive.
But it was a motivation.
You need basically you need to see the ground picture. You need to see where you're entering first.
And if you're not entering, you're missing something.
You cannot run away from the field. You have to be there. You have to be ready for the fight. So at least you see the ground picture, what's happening. So DVT, it was like every subject, they give like a specific time depending on how much they matter. And it was like a whole recap. All these subjects, like they are put a schedule in such a manner that they are very much interlinked. So that was really
The beauty of Dr. Sumer sir.
No, that was really helpful.
So apart from this all academic section, these 3 days, was it a motivation for you to revise in a very fast mode this DVT segment?
Yes, DVT basically it gave me a little more, lot more confidence, basically, because some things used to, like whenever faculty used to say something, it used to come back to you, ki haan, I remember that, and basically used to strengthen what your concepts were. So yeah, I mean, it's not possible to revise the whole thing in 3 days, but what DVT does is it cooks up everything and they give it to you. So that is the best thing you can do to yourself. before the exams, I think.
And before this AIMS examination, how many times you revise all these class notes?
Basically, like I said, I have been developing on my class notes ever since, like since I joined third year foundation, and I have been developing on those. I've been adding my points to that. So for profs also, I was reading those notes. So they were like my textbook. By the end of the year, they became my textbook. So I was reading like my subjects. I used to read my subjects from that. I'm not saying that you shouldn't read textbooks. I read my notes, and then I put all the important points from the textbook into those notes. So you shouldn't compromise on that, on the textbook part. But you need to realize that when you're going for a PG exam, you need something which you can go through in like a week or 15 days sometime. There are 19 subjects, and if you're not able to revise those, then you need to be a little confident, because you cannot go through textbooks. That's what I was preparing from third year. Both of them, they have equal importance. You cannot just substitute one for the another. But you need notes. You need notes, no doubt about that.
Nutshell, class notes, DAMS class notes are the more than sufficient for his complete stuff, which complete is required stuff. For your central institute examination. Again, in the last spell, when you appeared for the CBT, what was your rank in CBT?
I scored 70.
Rank 70. Very good. Yeah, great. So after getting that rank 70, did you get the confidence, yes, I'm going for AIMS, I will be getting somewhere rank in the top 100. How was the experience with the CBT, all the MCQs, level of MCQs, how beneficial they were?
I mean, the CBT is like they arrange the questions in such a manner that they are supposed to mimic the Central Institute examination. So, yeah, I've appeared for CBT, I've appeared for AIMS now. So, I think I can recall that they were pretty similar. And it was really competitive.
Everybody is taking now CBT as a gold standard for all India examination, AIMS examination, and you are getting such a nice, awesome rank of 9. So, you are the best student. You can say you are the best candidate who can say, if I compare CBT with AIMS, that same level was there, or CBT level slightly on the higher side?
To be honest, I found it a little tough, since we are preparing for something,
I think we need to be
on the higher side. We need to be on the higher side, because if we are preparing for something, if you want to really, really go with it, then you cannot under expect something. You need to over expect it.
Thanks a lot, Dr. Piyush, for such golden words, and I am confident every medico must be taking these golden words, and they will follow your steps to get such a nice rank. And now, coming on the DAMS faculties, which faculties motivate you maximum in the last 3 years? Which faculty you feel they motivate you best?
I believe everyone played their role. Everyone had their role. You cannot put one above the other. If still I have to say something I would just say Sumir sir, I liked the way he was practicality. I really like
everybody. He's a big inspiration for everybody.
Yeah, he's very practical person. So I really liked about him. Not just the subject. Obviously, he's a master of radiology. Right. No doubt about that. Every other faculty at DAMS is at their respective fields. But I really enjoyed listening to his practical he used to give out practical life points. I really enjoyed that.
Great. And whom you dedicate this success? If I ask you, you're getting such an awesome rank of 9 in AIMS, and I ask you, whom you dedicate this rank?
This belongs to my parents. I cannot.
Very good. Yeah. I am happy to listen these words, and I want that you should say a few words for them on this platform, and this video will be lifelong. You can dedicate these words to them.
I mean, I cannot it's not possible to emphasize enough what role they played. They already know that. I'm not very vocal about it, but they already know that how much I respect them, and this whole thing, if not for them, I wouldn't be here. I wouldn't even be close to this point. I cannot ever have made it through the internship maybe.
That's all their blessing.
Yeah, it's all their blessing. It's all their hard work. They put in a lot of motivation. My father always used to say, don't worry, even if you don't get in, it won't matter. But deep down in you, he's working hard.
He's working.
It's all dedicated to them. My friends from MBBS college, they also play a very vital role, because they used to come up with we used to sit down, and once in a while we used to have some productive discussion.
Absolutely.
I have a lot of people to thank. They already know
that play important role.
They play important role, no doubt about that.
And any special advice to all the juniors who are taking your words as golden?
I mean, they should pick on the pattern now that is changing. Obviously, the examiner wants you to be like more clinically oriented. The questions also that I saw in this year, they were very clinically oriented, like nothing that you would not expect an intern to know.
Yeah,
you need
agreed,
to know.
Absolutely.
Nothing that you shouldn't be aware of that. Basically, they were pointing towards that. They have videos now.
They're asking about integrated MCQ instead of asking one anatomy or physio.
Yeah.
They're integrating with patho, micro, as well as medicine. Yeah.
They don't That's care about individual fractional points. They care about the whole thing. They want you to know like what an intern is supposed to know. So I think let's start off with that. Be a little more vigilant during your classes, during internships. Be like, once you're in the intern, like, don't just close your eyes, be a little more observant. That's what matters. I mean, if you're more observant, it'll help you a lot. It'll give you a clinical acumen, which is very much needed in this
exam. Thanks a lot, Dr. Piyush, for such golden words, such golden advice for everybody. We are confident everybody will follow it. Very best of luck for upcoming days, and we wish you very best of luck on the behalf of DEMS family. Thanks a lot.
Thanks a lot, sir.
Such words.